ICT 47, Thivang Sandarvan Dasanayake. Today I am going to talk about cryptocurrency. First, we talk about what is cryptocurrency. Cryptocurrency is decentralized digital money based on blockchain technology. You may be familiar with the most popular version, Bitcoin and Ethereum, but there are more than 5,000 different cryptocurrencies in circulation. According to CoinLaw, you can use crypto to buy regular goods and service, although many people invest in cryptocurrencies as they would in other assets like stocks or precious metals. While cryptocurrency is a novel and exciting asset class, purchase it can be risky as you must take on a fair amount of research to fully understand how each system works. Now we check what are the differences between conventional currencies and digital currencies. You can see conventional currencies type is real, but cryptocurrencies type is virtual. Conventional currency intermediate is intermediate, and cryptocurrency is not intermediate. Conventional currency durable is moderate. Cryptocurrency is highly durable. Conventional currencies acceptance in national, but cryptocurrencies we can use in global through the internet. Conventional currency issued by government, cryptocurrencies are not issued by government. Then we talk about why use cryptocurrency. There are so many features of the cryptocurrencies. Let's talk about some. Cryptocurrency is fast, safe and cheap. It's easy to easy for use and highly portable, and it's untraceable. We can use anonymous transaction with cryptocurrency. It's transparent and neutral. It's freedom. We have freedom to transact. Okay, then we talk about what are the risks of cryptocurrencies. Hackers using this cryptocurrency method to attack advanced security systems and get money, and cost. Cryptocurrencies can cost consumer much more to use than credit. Credit cards or even regular cash, often due to price volatility, and scams. Okay, now we have to talk about types of cryptocurrencies. World mostly famous cryptocurrency is Bitcoin, then Ethereum. There are 191 billion Bitcoin in the world. There are so many cryptocurrencies in our world, but we normally using Ethereum and Bitcoin. Now we talk about example of cryptocurrency. I am going to talk about Bitcoin. Bitcoin using both cryptocurrency and electronic payment system. It's found by Satoshi Nakamoto in 2008. This is the first decentralized payment network. This using peer-to-peer system. This is completely open source. One Bitcoin same to $80,000+. Okay, now we have to talk about Bitcoin technology. Bitcoin, we can mine or buy. There are so many server machine to need to mining. We can easily buying using our wallet. Bitcoin transaction works like this. Person one is there and he transfer money as dollar, and he exchange money to BTC. Then person A have BTC and he send to person B. Then person B convert again Bitcoin to dollar. Then he can withdraw the amount. Conclusion: cryptocurrency is an impressive technical achievement, but it remains a monetary experiment. Even if cryptocurrencies survive, they may not fully displace fiat currencies. As I have tried to show in this presentation, they provide an interesting new perspective from which to view economic questions surrounding currency governance, the current characteristics of money, the political economy of financial intermediaries, and the nature of currency competition. I using this reference to find this valuable information. YouTube and Wikipedia and Bitcoin.org. My presentation is over. Thank you.